Hi, my name is Amanda McWhirt. I'm a horticulture specialist with the University of Arkansas System Division of Agriculture. And today we're at the University of Arkansas Fruit Research Station here in Clarksville, Arkansas. And we're going to talk about summer tipping of primocane fruiting blackberries. Now, summer tipping is something that's really important for both primocane fruiting types and floricane fruiting types because it's a way to increase branching. So basically what we're going to do is we're going to come in, pinch out the end of the growing point of our primocanes, and that's going to release some lower lateral branches to grow out over which we're then going to produce fruit. But there's some unique things that are kind of different about primocane fruiting blackberries that we want to talk about today. And I do want to point out that we did a winter pruning video for primocane fruiting blackberries, so make sure you go check that out. That talks a lot about the differences between primocanes and floricanes. But I do want to recap briefly what the different parts of the plant are now that we're in season so that you can kind of see what a floricane looks like in the middle of June versus a primocane. So let's do that here first. So blackberries are unique because they have two cane types. So the first year, a new cane comes up and grows and generally is vegetative, except for with primocane fruiting blackberries. And with primocane fruiting blackberries, those primocanes will actually produce a crop. So the easy way to kind of distinguish between what a primocane looks like is that they're usually really green and vegetative, sometimes have a different color. So here behind me is a planting of Primark Traveler, which is a University of Arkansas release and is a primocane fruiting type. So if you look here, you're going to see some different cane types. Here where we're seeing fruit production now in mid-June, the leaves are a little bit smaller. These are our floricanes. And so you can see that here in mid-June, we're starting to reach the end of the fruiting season on the floricane. But you'll also see here behind us some of these bigger, more vigorous canes, and these are going to be our primocanes. One of the easy ways to generally tell the difference is the number of leaves in the sets of leaflet. So let's come in here and pull a primocane leaf. So what's kind of unique about primocane leaves is that they come in sets of five. So here is one leaf off of a single petiole, and if you count the leaflets, there are five. And so that's characteristic of a primocane. Versus a floricane, if we come in here and pull a floricane leaf, you'll see that they are in sets of three. And so that's one way that you can kind of distinguish between the two canes. The other thing that you'll notice about this floricane here, so this is a floricane from last year, is that it has already produced a lot of flowers and fruit and is now basically at the end of its season. So the floricane is the early spring, or late spring, early summer crop, versus our primocanes. If you come in and look at those, here's a primocane in the back that has the five leaves, you'll see that it's just now starting to flower and produce fruit. So this is going to be our secondary crop that's going to come off more in midsummer and into fall. So those are some easy ways that you can distinguish between a primocane versus a floricane and a primocane fruiting blackberry. Here in the summer, we're going to actually be doing our tipping on the primocanes. And this is important because the primocanes are actively growing right now in June. And so this is our chance to impact how they grow and increase that branching. So essentially what we're going to do with tipping is just come in and pinch out or remove the end of the growing point. Now, in horticultural speak, that's called removing the apical dominance. But essentially all that does is it changes how the plant grows. So if we come in and pinch out the growing point, it's going to release buds lower down on the cane that are then going to produce side lateral branches that increase that branching and eventually increase the places where the plant can produce flowers and produce fruit. So if we actually look in here on this floricane, this was a cane from last year that grew last summer. You can actually see where it was tipped last summer. So it was tipped right here, and then it created all of these side lateral branches. And now here in this year, you see that fruit is being produced out at the ends of all of those branches. So similarly, on these primocanes, we want to do that tipping so that we get that branching so that the primocane fruit that is produced on those branches. And then next year on floricanes, we also get a similar amount of fruit production. The other thing to keep in mind is that there's really two types of tipping that can be done. The preferred method to do tipping is what is called a soft tip. And this is done on canes that are still really fleshy and green and have kind of a smaller diameter. So this is a primocane that is ready to do a soft tip. And essentially what we're gonna do is we're gonna come in and remove the top 2 inches of the cane with our fingers. And that's a soft tip. This is preferable because you do it on a cane that is a smaller diameter, so you leave a lot smaller wound here. And also it can be done with your fingers, so it can be quite quick. However, if we look at some of these canes back here in the back, these have gotten really tall and they're starting to get a little bit more woody. I'm not gonna be able to come in with my fingers and actually tip these. So what I'm gonna have to do is what is called a hard tip, and this is gonna require pruners. So I'm actually gonna come in with my pruners. I want this cane to be tipped here at the height of the top wire. Use my pruners to remove that cane. And you'll notice that what I cut out has a lot bigger diameter. So I'm creating a lot bigger wound in that cane. And that's gonna potentially leave that cane open to increasing the amount of disease that may move into that cane. And so this is a little bit more risky. We wanna try and avoid doing hard tipping when we can. Mostly what you want to watch with soft tipping versus hard tipping also goes back to the timing of when you're doing tipping. So I mentioned that we're here in the middle of June. We're actually a little bit late to be doing a lot of our tipping on soft primocanes. And we really should have been doing a lot of this tipping probably closer to the early part of June when primocanes were just starting to reach this level. But I'll show you here in a second. We did some tipping a few weeks back, and I'm going to be able to show you kind of what the result is and those side lateral branches starting to form. The other thing that you might want to keep in mind is if you're double cropping or single cropping. Now, we talked about this in our previous winter video, but in the Southeast, most growers are probably doing a double crop unless they're in a really cool region and able to get away with a single crop. But depending on if you're doing a double crop or a single crop, will change the height at which and the timing of when you want to do your tipping. So if you're doing a single cropping, you're not going to ever fruit on your floricanes. You're only going to be fruiting on your primocanes every year, and then you're going to remove those primocanes at the base. But if you are doing that single cropping, you do still want those primocanes to branch so that you have more lateral branches, and at the end of each one of those branches, then you get more fruit production. But tipping in that case is going to be a lot easier because as primocanes first start to come up in the spring, generally what we would recommend is that you may want to actually mow those to the ground and force them to flush out and grow again later so that you can kind of force that crop to be a little bit later. And then you would do a tipping and get a fruit production that's going to be later season and quite low. If, however, you're going to be doing the double cropping where you want a crop on the primocanes in late fall and then you also want a crop in early spring on the floricanes like what we're doing here, you're actually going to tip a little bit differently because you're going to try and carry these canes over the winter. So what we did here was we let those primocanes get up to about the top height of the wire. We pinched them, as I mentioned before. They produced these side lateral branches, and then we got a crop last summer, and now we're getting another crop here in the spring. But some work has actually been done out in Oregon and the western part of the United States showing that we can actually even maximize production on primocane fruiting blackberries further by doing what is called a double tip. And so this basically means that you do a single tip on the main cane that comes up, and then as these lateral branches start to develop, you do a second tip, so that's the double tip, on those lateral branches so that you get additional branching off of these side branches. We've not done a lot of research on that here in Arkansas to see if that works just as well. We still struggle with having really high heat in the summer, and that really limits our primocane potential on primocane fruiting blackberries. But it's something to investigate and see if you might want to do a double tipping. If you do that double tipping, very likely you're not going to want to tip at this height for your first tip. You're going to want to tip closer to about 3 feet and then let those lateral branches grow about 1.5 feet and then do your second tipping on those lateral branches when they're about 1.5 feet long. All right, let's take a closer look at what actually happens after you do the tipping on these primocanes and start to see those lateral branches develop. So here we are looking at a primocane that was soft tipped about 2 weeks ago. And so if you come in here to the end of the cane, you can actually see the wound from where we removed the tip of the cane and did that soft tip. And then if you come in and look at the nodes that are just below, you see all of these side lateral branches that are starting to form. so that we're starting to get that branching. So just in 2 weeks, you can already see that plant starting to produce those side lateral branches. And so this is what we would like to see, though I will say that this cane was probably tipped a little bit later than when we really would have liked. We probably should have tipped it about a week or so before when it was tipped. This was a soft tip, and then I also have an example of a cane that was hard tipped about 2 weeks ago. And so this is that cane here. If we come in and look at the end of that cane, you can see that the wound is a lot larger. It's a little bit calloused over now. This was done with a hard tipping. And so of course, this is what we would like to try and avoid, but sometimes it is unavoidable. Generally, we recommend that if you do have to do a hard tipping that you make a fungicide application afterwards. But the effect is the same. We did that hard tipping here, and now all those nodes below that tipping, you start to see these lateral branches that are starting to form, even all the way back to here. So we're starting to get that branching developing, and that's what we would like to see. Thanks so much for joining us here at the Fruit Research Station to learn a little bit more about summer tipping of primocane fruiting blackberries. Thanks so much for watching.